Hare Krishna. The body reacts mechanically. Don't take its reactions personally. Suppose we see some delicious food. Naturally, on seeing that food, our tongue might start salivating. And now we may have decided, may say it's a fasting day, and we have decided to abstain from grains. Now, just because the tongue has started salivating doesn't mean that we are weak in determination, and it doesn't definitely mean that we have to start eating it. So the body has a mechanical mode of functioning by which certain perceptions produce certain reactions. So when we understand this body as a mechanical unit, mechanical means a particular cause will produce a particular effect. So now we as souls who are different from the body can become the observers of this mechanical action-reaction chain and not get involved in it. So that this same principle applies, say we see some attractive sense object. Then again the body might react by getting somewhat stimulated. Now when that happens, it's just a mechanical reaction of the body, but that doesn't mean that we ourselves have a character flaw because of which we are getting tempted. No, it is only when we entertain that desire, when we dwell on that desire and then we succumb to that desire, then that is when it's a weakness that we need to deal with. But it is just otherwise the body getting stimulated or reacting in particular ways to particular stimuli is simply a mechanical reaction. And to take its reactions personally means to think that these reflect some flaw within us. Rather than that, we can just see that this is just a mechanical reaction. I don't have to get personally involved in it. Just let the reaction come, the reaction will stay, the reaction will go. So this view of the body as a mechanical contraption is recommended by the Bhagavad-Gita in 5.8 and 9. So therein Krishna says, it talks about various actions performed with the body. Ashnan, gachan, swapan, swashan, pralapan, visrujan, grihanan, unmishan, nimishan, napi, indriyan, indriyartheshu, vartanta iti dharayan. So activity like seeing, touching, walking, all these activities Krishna says that indriyan, indriyartheshu, it is simply the senses coming in contact with the sense object. That you don't have to get personally involved in it. And the next verse gives us the mood in which we can stay detached. So it says that brahmanyadhaya karmani sangam tyaktva karoti yah lipyatena sa papena badmapatramivambhasa. So if we work with the body for the purpose of serving Krishna, then we won't be affected at all. The important thing is that if we don't take the reactions of the body personally, then we won't invest our emotion and our consciousness in it, and those reactions, they'll come at the physical level and they will disappear at the physical level. If we invest our emotion, they will rise from the physical to the emotional, and from the emotional they will drag our consciousness down to the sensual level. But by just objectively observing those reactions, they will come and they will go, and we will keep moving onwards in our purposeful spiritual journey. Thank you. Hare Krishna.